Friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the most important topics and most important preparation strategies and instructions regarding TCS NQT 2020 exam. It is going to begin within less than 20 days, that is on August 3rd and 4th. So this video helps you a lot, helps you the candidates who are going to attend this exam a lot. So watch this video till the end to crack the TCS NQT 2020 exam. So now let's begin the video. Coming to the quantitative aptitude, you're going to have 15 questions and 30 minutes. So at max, 30 seconds is the duration which you can give to solve a particular question. So concentrate on important topics of all the sections which I'm going to tell you. So coming to the quantitative aptitude, important topics are simplification, time, distance and speed, profit and loss, percentages, blood relations, geometry, clocks and calendars. These are the topics where you need to concentrate most of the time, like, you know, concentrate mostly, and these are the topics which consumes more time. Okay, so please concentrate on these particular topics. And now I'm going to give you the topic wise tips for quantitative aptitude. Coming to the number system, the questions mostly will be asked which are very basic, which does not take you more than 15 seconds to solve. And concentrate on simplifications, equations and all, which are basic, which gives you more marks. And coming to the HCF, LCM, you'll have just 2 to 3 formulae, which you have to keep in your mind. If you have that in mind, you can solve the HCF, LCM questions in less than 20 seconds. They'll just ask you the basic questions, not so tough questions regarding the simplification and HCF, LCM. So now coming to the time, speed and distance, mixtures and allegations. These two are the most important and difficult topics which consumes most of your time. So most of the students waste their time by trying to solve these particular problems, that is the problems on time, speed and distance and mixtures and allegations. So just give at max of 40 seconds or 50 seconds for these problems. If you are unable to solve, please skip to next question, because you should not take the risk of guesswork, because you have negative marking. And don't waste your time, because time management is very important in scoring more marks and in giving the tough competition for other candidates. So concentrate on time management importantly. Okay, and coming to the percentages, the questions will be like really basic, really easy, and there are 4 to 5 formulae. You should always have that in your mind to solve within 20 seconds, like less than 20 seconds. Percentage problems is must. So coming to the series, the questions are going to be present in your exam, because coming to series, there are two category kind of questions they're going to ask you. Coming to the series, first question which they may ask you is, they'll give you the series of a number series, and they'll ask you what is the wrong number in the given series. Okay, you should find out which is the wrong number in the series. That is one kind of problem. And second kind of question which they may ask you is that they'll give you a series, like, you know, some 5 numbers for example, and they'll ask you what number may be present at the 6th position. Okay, or what number may come in the place of question mark. So these two kinds of questions in series are very frequently asked in TCS NQT exam. So please concentrate on these two kind of problems as well. And coming to the blood relations, there is one useful and helpful tip which I'm going to give you. Coming to the blood relation, they'll give you a question, right? They'll give you a small paragraph of the question. Start solving the question. Start reading the question from the last. For example, the question is that they've given 2 to 3 lines of question. And the last main question is that, How is A related to B? This is the main question, right? So have that question in your mind and start reading the question from the last sentence to the first sentence, okay? So this particular technique will help you to solve any kind of blood relation problem in less than 30 seconds. Trust me, it's wonderful technique. It's going to help you a lot, okay? So coming to the other basic questions like averages and algebra, it's very easy, basic, and concentrate mostly on the useful and important scoring topics which I've told you. Don't forget, and concentrate on clocks and calendars. There will be simple techniques for these two particular topics, clocks and calendars. If you know that techniques, any problem you're going to solve within less than 15 seconds, 15, okay? So there are going to like you know, I'm going to make more and more videos regarding the simple formulae and simple techniques to solve any kind of quantitative aptitude problems coming to each and every particular topic. So also concentrate on geometry. The chance of asking the toughest problems such as geometry and all will be very less. It depends upon your luck, because most of the times this paper is going to be very easy, and you may skip one or two hard topics in order to manage your time. But if the paper is so tough, they takes the percentile as your consideration, they will not give the cutoff as percentage. They will always decide the cutoff based upon the percentile and based upon the toughness of the paper. So be confident. Now let's see what are the tips I would like to give you coming to the programming MCQs. Coming to the programming MCQs, they are very easy. They'll be asking you 10 MCQs and you'll be having 20 minutes. It's like you can get 2 minutes per question. And they'll be asking you out of 10 questions, 7 questions will be easy to moderate, only 3 questions will be tough and logical. So coming to this particular programming, they'll ask you questions such as they'll give you the program and they'll ask you what may be the output of this program, okay? And they'll ask you other questions like the basic questions. Such as tree, stack, and all, okay, the basic questions, and you can score more in this particular section, that is programming language MCQs, and concentrate on the important topics now, which I'm going to tell you. Concentrate on sorting, okay, binary search, sorting algorithms, and looping, recursion, iteration, and data types, arrays, stacks. These are the few topics which are very important. Arrays, stacks, queues, only the basic questions they'll be asking you, which are easy to moderate. They're not going to ask you high level questions, so be confident and be happy. And coming to the coding, they'll just ask you one question and they'll give you 30 minutes of time where you can use any language, C, C++, Perl, or Python, Java, any language you can use. But the thing is, you should get the correct output which they asked you to get, okay? The maximum duration is 30 minutes for one particular program, and use the language which you are very confident in, and the language which saves you a lot of time, okay? So and the basically complete to the compared to the previous papers, year by year the toughness is increasing. So concentrate mostly on the coding, because one single question is going to change your score and change your percentile. And the thing is, there is no time limit how many times ever you can write the code, how many times you can compile the code or run the code. There are no restrictions. So be calm, use a complete 30 minutes for the code, and they'll be asking you the basic programs. So for example, they'll give you a word and they'll ask you to write a program to print the word in the reverse order, or to write a program to give the output of how many vowels or consonants are present in that particular word. So such kind of simple and the basic programs they're going to ask, so you need not panic. So last but not least, coming to the English, concentrate mostly on the parajumbles and direct and indirect speech and close test grammar, because grammar, you should have the basic knowledge of the grammar. And coming to the spotting errors, the 99% of the errors will be the basic words which misses out, like they'll wantedly miss out the word in, of, and all. They'll ask you to find the errors in that particular sentence. So the basic questions, the basic things, you must have the complete and the good knowledge about the grammar, which helps you to save a lot of time coming to this English. And tips regarding English are, coming to sentence completion, it's very easy, it's going to be very easy. And direct and indirect speech, the basic questions, and concentrate mostly on parajumbles, because most of the students are going to run out of the time just by solving parajumbles. So practice more and more, coming to the parajumbles. And coming to basic grammar and the close passage, it's very easy. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such useful videos. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. And do follow all these tips which I've told you in this video in order to crack the TCS NQT exam. And also all the very best for your exam, as well as the interview which is going to happen once you qualify the online exam. So thanks for watching, subscribe and hit the bell icon, like and share.